satisfy you with it. For you are God, and we thank you for your visitation. We thank you, God, for lifting us to another level, another level, another level this week. Oh, God Almighty, and we welcome you in this service. One more time, take authority. Be God over us in the name of Jesus Christ. Move upon us in an extraordinary way. There is more to go, for there are levels, deeper depths, higher heights in you in the name of Jesus Christ. There are new levels in you that you want to continue tonight, and you have ordered this conference just how you want it to be. Hallelujah. In your order, in your power, in your presence, in your spirit, you have ordered this service tonight just how you want it to be. And we thank you. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. And we give you the praise. For you alone are God. And we worship you. Thank you for your Holy Spirit. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your compassion. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your mercies that endure forever. We give you the praise and the glory. For thine, O God Almighty Jesus Christ, is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Move in this place tonight continually. In another level, for words fail us, but we thank you, God. We are not worthy, but we thank you for being among us. We are nothing, but we thank you for moving in this conference in an extraordinary way. God, we appreciate you, and so we ask you to keep us in this level that you have lifted us. Keep our minds, keep our minds. For the enemy is going to come after our minds to confuse us. In the name of Jesus, the spirit of the Leviathan that will twist our minds. But keep us remembering how you showed up in this place tonight, that we will be firm in our beliefs in what you're doing. And this new level that we are in, we ask you, God, to keep us. In this new authority that you have given us, keep us. We look to you, Jesus Christ, the healer, from whence cometh our help. For we know our help cometh from you, Lord God Almighty Jesus, who made heaven and earth. We open our hearts and our minds and our spirits and our bodies to you, Jesus Christ. And we give you the honor and the glory and the praise. For you, O Lord, are worthy, Jesus Christ. You alone are worthy, as we lift our hearts and our spirits and our minds and bow in submission to you, God Almighty, and listen to what you have to say tonight to us again. Together, we lift our spirits. Let's lift our hands and our hearts and give the Lord praise. Welcome the Holy Spirit and the presence of God in a new level tonight. Hallelujah. Let us all stand, brethren, and do this together. For Jesus Christ is God, and he is worthy to be praised. Lift our spirit in one heart, one mind, one accord, one prayer, one praise. For on the day of Pentecost, if the church was not on one accord, there would be no Holy Spirit coming. So let us be one tonight in mind, body, and spirit, that when the Lord will lift us, that God Almighty will have no hindrance. No hindrance, but he will do so in a raboshekaka, rebekoshekandere dabohosea, yeturibe eshe, eturibe hai. In the name of Jesus, we give you the glory and we give you the honor and the praise. God, welcome in this place. We thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercies. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. We thank you. Let's clap our hands together. What can we say to these things? But just together in oneness, in mind and body and spirit, just receive of the Lord tonight. For there is more to come. And I pray that our minds will be able to contain it. Let it be so, Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us worship the Lord right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us give him thanks. Hallelujah for what we have heard all this week. Our hearts rejoice and our tongues are made glad by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Let us clap our hands unto the Lord right now as we worship him. The Bible said we should enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. Has he done anything for you? Hallelujah. Let us worship him for his goodness. Hallelujah. The scripture said, oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Majesty, worship his majesty. Be your glory, honor. morning star. What is his name? Hallelujah. There is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. I thank God. I thank God for the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I thank God for his name. Jesus is the sweetest name I know. And he's just the same as his lovely name.
Say amen. God be the glory. Bishop Thomas, amen. And ORAC, this is my place where I get filled up. When I come to ORAC, I get filled up. And I'm so glad that I was able to get filled up this week. Bishop, thank you once again for the steady hand of leadership at the Open Apostolic Tabernacle in my life and the ministry there. I appreciate ORAC. I appreciate the stand that ORAC takes, and I appreciate Bishop Thomas and his steady hand of leadership. And, you know, I was reading in Acts chapter 16 when Paul and Silas went to Philippi, and they faced much opposition there. And if it was just up to them, they probably would have just went back home or went to another place in Asia Minor. But they stayed there, and Paul rebuked the spirit that was there in that territory, in that region. And that was a territorial spirit there. That spirit, if you study that spirit of the python, that was a territorial spirit there. And but in overcoming that spirit, not only did they just break out of prison, and the preacher talked about breaking the limits last night, but they were able to also break that region, whatever spirit that was in that region. And that region was able to support Paul in his ministry financially, amen, with their prayers. And I'm just proclaiming victory in Mount Vernon in Brooklyn, that we are taking over, and we are putting the enemy under our feet. We're crushing that spirit that's been holding back progress for the kingdom of God. Amen. Praise God. And I'm saying that not only is this city going to be, amen, praise God, a place that we conquer as far as the spirits are concerned, but, amen, they're going to support us in ministry financially. Mount Vernon is going to support this church. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Canarsie is going to be supporting our church. Amen. Because the Bible says the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church of the living God. Can somebody stand to your feet and give God a praise that we have victory in this midnight end time hour? We're going to have victory.
Come on, lift your hands, everybody. Give the Lord a show of praise. Clap your hands like the devil is between them. Come on. Clap your hands like the devil is between them. Hallelujah. Somebody shout fire. My God, my God. Something is about to take off in this house right now. Are you ready? Are you ready? Hallelujah. Feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. It's such a joy to be in conference focus, kingdom focus conference, or kingdom conference focus, kingdom authority conference focus. Amen. It's all about the kingdom. It's all about authority. It's all about focus. Amen. I'm so glad to be here. Praise the name of the Lord. Sister Clark and myself, we are overjoyed to be able to be in the conference at this time. Although we are, we miss home, but we're glad to be here because we're still in family. Amen. Greetings, Bishop and Sister Thomas. Praise the name of the Lord. I became engrafted in the Thomas's family. Amen. Bishop and Sister Thomas happened to be, amen, my mother and father. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord, my father-in-law. And of course, the fraternities of bishops that are here tonight. Amen. We have Dr. Scott, Elder Scott. Amen. He's my son in the Lord. Praise. I'm so proud of him. Amen. God has blessed him with a powerful medical gifting that he should be in the medical fraternity working, but it has switched to preaching. Amen. And we're proud of him. Come on, clap your hands and put your hands together for amen, amen, amen. Bishop McHugh, praise the name of the Lord. The fraternities of elders and ministers that are of the ORAC clergy, amen, praise the name of the Lord. They're sitting in the front row here. Praise the name of the Lord. Elder Brown, amen, praise the Lord. Elder Thomas, Minister, my younger brother, amen. Minister Thomas, I heard him preach the other night, and I was just pushing him to preach. I was waiting for that for a long time, because I told him, long time, just wait on the Lord, and he will use you in his own time. Praise the name of the Lord. All the members of the clergy that are here present, pray, God bless you, Elder Bertram. Amen. All the leaders, the overseers, amen, the pastors, the bishops, amen, the choristers, beautiful choristers, the musicians, the technicians, the multimedia personnel, and to all the precious saints of light, precious faith, to all the leaders and overseers and shouters and mourners and wailers and clappers and dancers and singers and givers and hallelujah. May the Lord richly bless you tonight. It is such a joy to be here. Amen. You have an awesome pastor. You have an awesome pastor. He is awesomely gifted to lead. Amen. God has placed in him a very unique leadership ability. Amen. And we want to give God thanks. Thanks for him. Come on, put your hands together for the mayor. Amen. 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 We see mayors get the Holy Ghost, and they don't just get the Holy Ghost. They preach to. Amen. Amen. They lead to. And I can see he's getting ready for a breakout. It's getting ready for a breakout. Somebody shout hallelujah. My God. I'm going to take my seat, but I sense that the heaven is open tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I slipped over to just to join my brother from the conference. It's not disrespect, but he had his 60-year celebration, 60th birthday. Amen. He's 60 years young. Amen. The handsome one in Jersey. Praise the Lord. Amen. And so Sister Clark and myself, we run off to be with him. I preach for him today. The Lord is blessing the work. It's like a branch church from the Cayman Islands, if you know it. Amen. We baptize 11 people in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ today. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord is moving. Somebody clap your hands and give God a praise for what he's going to do in this house tonight.
Praise God for revival. Amen. It certainly gives me pleasure to extend greetings to our host pastor, Honorable Bishop, and Lady Thomas, and to all the other generals, amen, sitting on the form and in the clergy, especially to our Honorable Mayor who is here. Thank God for people who, like David said, the people, amen, that know God are blessed. Amen. Blessed are the people whose God is the Lord. Amen. Amen. They are blessed, and we thank God amen, for such people. We are certainly, I'm speaking on behalf of my wife and myself, amen, we are certainly having a great time. Amen. Every now and then I've got to take somebody back home in Jamaica and say, look here, I'm in the midst of an awesome, amen, presence of God. Amen. And I certainly have enjoyed this conference. It has really changed me. I'm going back to Jamaica differently. I don't even know what I'm going back there to do now, but I'm certainly, amen, going to be more warlike. I am a warrior. Amen. If you want to hurt me, try to stop my praise. Amen. I just want a chance to praise the Lord. Amen. And because of that, I can tell Pastor McHugh, amen, I'm so glad I've been to Arabia. Amen. And that trip has transformed my life. And I'm going to continue that transformation. God bless you.
We want to worship the Lord by way of giving tonight. We certainly appreciate your support for this conference. It takes a lot to organize and prepare for a conference of this magnitude. And so we thank you today for your response. Amen. Some of you promised that you would bring it back this evening, and I'm here to take it. Amen. You're people of your word. And I like that, because you serve a God who's a God of his word. Amen. Praise the Lord. But anyhow, we certainly appreciate your response to it. We would like, when tomorrow morning comes, all of the expenses are taken care of and there's no red ink on the books. Amen. I don't know about you, but I have a couple of cards, credit cards, but they don't manage me. I manage them. I don't carry any bills over for the next month because I hate paying interest. Because those who are taking it don't need it. I'm telling you, they have more than that they can handle. So why should I give them mine if I don't have to give them? No, not me. So I manage my credit card. I say that to say this, that I don't like when the balance sheet is not balanced. Amen. So please help us. We try to be good stewards of the funds that you have contributed to this church. And we report to you what is done and what is left. We always do. You know that. Amen. So you can be confident that your giving is going to the right place. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you. Stand with me. Lord, we thank you for your people tonight who have been so willing contributors to your cause, to your kingdom. And for that, Lord, because of them, we are able to do ministry without any burden. Amen. And we thank you, Lord, and we appreciate you. Continue your loving kindness upon them. Prosper their way and make provisions in the time of their needs. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God. Tell your neighbor, these are the days of Elijah. Come on, tell your neighbor. How many of you know that? How many of you really believe that? And then tell your neighbor, there is no God like Jehovah. Anybody in the house believe there's no God like Jehovah? Praise God. Hallelujah. These are the days
of Elijah. Declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert, crying.
Yes, he will.
Riding like the sun.
And the trumpet's
roar.
coming.
The dry bones becoming as flesh.
These are the days of your servant
these
David.
These are the days of your servant David. Rebuilding the temple of praise.
And these are the days of the harvest.
These are the days of the harvest.
The fields that are wide in your mind. God bless you. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Somebody shout Kingdom Focus 2017. Somebody shout Kingdom Focus 2017. Praise God, God's willing, if we're still here. If we're still here. I said if we're still here. Save the date. Kingdom Focus 2017, June 28th to July 2nd. Next year, you don't want to miss it. Tell your neighbor if we're still here, don't miss Kingdom Focus. Tell your boss, I'm taking that time, I'm taking that week, I don't care if I lose my job. Did I say that? Well, the preacher said last night, let's break the limits. No, don't tell your boss that. Just ask nicely for the time, take the time. But it's going to be a great time. Every year, God is just moving us to another dimension. And it's for a reason, because this is the last day. This is it. Where is the only thing left is for Jesus to crack those skies. But while we're waiting, we're going to be bringing his kingdom to bear on the city, on this world. Amen. So don't miss Kingdom Focus 2017, June 28th to the July 2nd. Save the date. Amen. Worship with our choir. Thank you.
could not be had it not been for Jesus. He transformed my life in the year 1967. Before that, I was a Marxist, revolutionist, communist. But thank God for my mother who went to Arabia. She died when I was 14. But she did something with God in Arabia. And so although I preached this doctrine for a time, God brought me into the family. And so all the praise and the glory goes to Jesus Christ. I love him. And thank you all for your prayers, Sister Brown. I appreciate that prayer. And Bishop, likewise, I appreciate that prayer. And I just want to remain faithful to the Lord. And my passion and my burden is to give my all and to do more and more for Jesus. Let me also implore you and beg you as a family to stand with and behind your leader, Bishop Thomas. As I said this morning, Jesus, who was God manifest in the flesh, before he started his ministry, the first thing he did, he chose 12 men. Why? His ministry could not and never be successful without men. And so I beg you, stand with him. Share his vision. Those who know to pray, pray for him. And don't forget Sister Thomas. She's the closest to him. And I'll tell you why. He works through the closest to us. And I know Sister Thomas will stay close to the Lord. And also, she will stay close to him. Thank God for faithful wives. And children, God bless you in Jesus' name. Thanks, Ryan. And the greatest thing that you can do to make me happy is to remain faithful to the Lord Jesus. Both yourself and your sister, thanks.
And then how can I say thanks to the army of men and women who work tirelessly to make this conference a success? Her church board, ministers, and to top the list, Reverend Dean Harvey. Praise God. He has made it so easy for us. Amen. Because of his relentlessness in pursuing the things of the Lord. And this conference has been consumed, Brother Dean, by Brother Dean. This conference consumed him. And he has been a source of blessing to this congregation. Amen. I can't say thank you enough, Brother Dean. And then there are some people, unsung heroes around the place, those who serve in the kitchen, amen, those who help us Sure. Those who help us to keep the place clean after every night, back in order. I want to give a big thank you to Brother Meredith. Very faithful brother to the work of the Lord. He sees everything that I don't see. And he don't ask any question. Just make sure that they are done. Thank you, Brother Meredith. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. I want to thank Sister T and Andrea and Michael who preach on Friday night. He provided the music for us for this conference, Brother Mark, Brother Clark, and Brother Shamar over the corner. Amen. And all of you. In Jesus' name. I know I'm missing some people, but please forgive me. God bless you. Everybody who sits on any of these chairs, we are so thankful that you came. We couldn't have a conference without you. Amen. I said we couldn't have a conference without you. Help me to tell your neighbor, thank you. Yeah. And then I want to sing Lord Brother Myrie for an excellent job. Excellent job in helping us in the parking lot. Praise God. Brother Steve, thank you. I'm not going to say it, but thank you. You know what I'm saying. Praise God. Amen. Thank you so much. Stand with me, please. I want to say how much we appreciate the ministry of Reverend Aggrey Scott. He has been a blessing. Allow the Lord to use him to bless his people. And many of us that are here, if not all, will not be the same. Will not be the same because the word of God has impacted our hearts. Amen. And we are prepared to rise up and to make a difference. Amen. Amen. Yes, praise God. Apply the word of God to our hearts. We promise you we are going to do that. Yes. Amen. And so thank you, sir, for making yourself available to the cause of the Lord. Giving yourself. You've made tremendous sacrifice, if I call it a sacrifice, because God is going to reward you for the decisions you make to give yourself to the ministry and to serve his kingdom. Let's put our hands together as we welcome. This one back.
Thank you, Bishop. Praise the Lord. Thank you, everyone. You may be seated in the presence of the mighty God. Amen, amen. I give honor to the presence of the Lord here tonight and standing on this very serious trampling ground, the place where the Holy Ghost moves without asking questions. Amen. I give due deference to Bishop Thomas and Lady Thomas, Dr. Clark, Bishop McHugh. All I've been calling him Bishop. Praise the Lord. And I don't think it's by mistake. Amen. To all of the entire cauldron of ministers and everyone in Jesus' name, I just piggyback on Bishop Clark's, greeting. Praise God. I love that kind of stuff. Everybody in Jesus' name, I salute you. And the matchless power of the mighty God. Amen. I never knew that I would be standing here tonight. Praise God. It is by divine arrangement. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. I was saying, okay, praise the Lord. Last night was, yes, wonderful, praise God. Amen. And I'm going home, amen. But the Lord said, I ain't finished with you yet. Hallelujah. Amen. And it is just a privilege to stand and to serve. I thank Bishop and the entire conference for allowing me the privilege. Praise the Lord. And when you're standing around people who are your mentors, such as Dr. Clark and Lady Clark, you know, you kind of get a little nervous. You know, it's just human pressure. Amen. When you know the generals are in the place, I don't know about you, praise God. But I'm not ashamed to say it, and some people are just ashamed to speak the truth. And when you are in the company of people that you look up to spiritually, it gives you the good kind of jitters, praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. God is a good God. And so before I take my seat, amen, I guarantee you that I'm going to mess with Dr. Clark this tonight here. Amen. When the apostles are in the house, you got to know to work like a team. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Amen, 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 amen. Give God glory and stop acting jealous. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Get all tight up in the church. Praise God. I greet my wife again, Sister Scott, and my little gang. Praise God. Could you stand? She was outside last night. And let everybody see who you are. Amen. Praise God. And that's my boo. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's my boo. Amen. Amen. I don't often do this, and she will tell you, praise God. Amen. But thank God for her. Amen. When we consider the moment that we're standing on and the time frame in which we live, when we look at several things concurrently, when you begin to amass a sense of an understanding of who you are, whose you are, why you are, how you came to be, and what is going on in your life, it gives you a certain sense of urgency. If you understand the times, and if you know, amen, your limitations in a good sense, and you know the sense to which God is leaning, or the direction in which God is leaning, praise God, you come to understand very quickly and very deeply that everything that concerns God and concerns you is done on purpose. It is deliberate. It is intentional. God doesn't make any mistakes. He doesn't review anything. He never needs to revise any edition of his will. It's always something different, amen, and progressively so. When we look, praise God, at this conference and how it has unfolded, I am telling you, praise God, I feel the word of God. When I go home, I don't sleep, hallelujah. I go to places several nights. I'm in China, amen. I'm in other places in the world, just the Holy Ghost carrying me, showing me things. I'm speaking different languages in an unusual way. I don't know if you sense it, but things are breaking and have broken. There is a sense of a convergence of time and space and prophecy and lives and the will and the mind of God. Amen. When you look into things and you begin to understand certain things in the kingdom, and one of them that God spoke to me about even this afternoon is the miraculous. When you look at the miraculous things that God does, every miracle, every sign, every super to the natural activity, it is meant to facilitate a witness. And the witness, praise God, is designed to create, hallelujah, a connection. And that connection is with God, the miracle worker. And then the connection is designed to bring you into relationship. And the relationship is designed, amen, to bring you into life. And the life experience is designed to carry you to another world while you live in your present world. And when you die, when you cease to exist on this side, the relationship is designed to carry you into another realm, which is called the eternal realm. I want to suggest to you that we are living simultaneously in the spirit realm as we are in the physical realm. You remember that a little bit from last night. Amen. The Bible says we are seated in heavenly places with Christ in God. So although we are sitting in the earth, literally, spiritually, we are occupying spiritual space, if you will, in the presence of God. And when you're in spiritual space, you're in eternity. Praise God. Even though you're still occupying time, eternity still continues while there is time. It's just a section of eternity that is called time. So then the relationship is meant to carry you to a different dimension, both in terms of space and in terms of how you experience the passage of time. We're going to move from time to eternity. That's what it's all about, you know. And God is going to carry us to another realm, another world. We're going to get an eternal body. We're going to have an eternal existence. It's not just about a Benz, a Bugatti, amen, a Mirelli. It's not about driving a Porsche alone. It's not about living in the house in the Hamptons on
the flip side, it's not just about walking in kingdom dynamics and under the power and the authority of the Holy Ghost, raising the dead and healing the sick and commanding elements to stand still like Joshua did the sun. There is more to it than that. You remember when the disciples came back to Jesus and they were ranting, my God, I can imagine they were giving high five and low five and side five, my God. Did you see those demons pack up? Did you see them burn tires like Scooby-Doo and Roadrunner? Can you imagine when we said, Jesus, hallelujah, did you see what happened? And they were exultant. They were mesmerized. They were stupefied. You know, everybody was saying, what a power. And notice, they didn't get the Holy Ghost yet. They were just operating by the declared word of God. But something that is unique about what Jesus said, he says, don't rejoice that even the very demons are subject to you. He says, rather rejoice on the ultimate reality. Hallelujah, that your names are written in the book of life. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how many demons we command to run. It doesn't matter how many signs and wonders we do, really. They take second place to the eternal state. Oh, somebody need to let your mind go there. We are traveling through time to get to eternity. We are traveling through corruption to get to incorruption. Oh, you gotta get the perspective. You gotta keep your mind focused, baby. Oh, yes, the devil has got to run. Oh, yes, we're gonna work miracles. But there is something ultimate. There is something higher. There is a quintessential purpose to everything that God does. You think we're bad yet? Wait till we get to the millennial kingdom.
All right, praise the Lord. Those of us that forgot our brains in the parking lot, I'm giving you 2 seconds to go grab it, because God says you're going to need it right now. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. When you come to a conclave like this, you got to get your spirit ready to step into a different realm of understanding and manifestation in the Holy Ghost. What God laid on my heart to share, and I hope to be very quick, I hope to be surgical tonight, is that it's time to commit, to connect, and to manifest. It's time. Look at your neighbor, eyeball them. Tell your neighbor, it's time to commit, to connect, and to grab your swords and split it with me to the angle again. This time to the last angle, Revelation 12, verse 7 through 11. Jesus, we give you the glory. I do feel like things have already begun to happen in the elements above your seat. Hallelujah. Over your heart. It's now or never. The Bible says in verse 8, I'd start, and prevailed not. Neither was their name found anymore in heaven. Speaking about Lucifer. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And I heard a voice saying in heaven, now, at that particular time, is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God, and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of the brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. Yes, Holy Ghost. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Everybody say, by the blood of the Lamb. And by the word of their testimony. Everybody say, their testimony. And they loved not their lives unto the death. Father, I am just a lump. I'm just a voice. God, have thine own way. Let me be the best superconductor of your voice and your word in this time, at the best time in my life and at this moment. Let nothing in me inhibit the flow of your spirit, and have thine own way, God, as I speak what you want me to say in Jesus' name. Sit down and give God glory one more time. Revelation is to the Bible what a good conclusion is to a good novel. It is the understanding of the consummation of the plan of God. Revelation serves many things, but one of them is that it gives perspective and solidifies our expectations and our hope.
A journey that is long and tumultuous and filled with a lot of hardship and challenges sometimes will cause you to become weary. I don't know if you've ever been there. Sometimes you may even wonder why you serve God. A long journey. Sometimes you get disillusioned. Sometimes you get carried away with the journey and forget that you started out to go to a certain destination. What the book of the Revelation does is that it gives us the perspective of how the story ends. When you know how the story ends, you can sit comfortably through the entire script. When you know how time ends, when you know how the devil ends up, when you know how the angels that defected with him, how they are treated, when you understand things about the white throne judgment and the books of God and the book of life, when you understand that all these people, including the devil, who think they are the final authority and that they are the be all and end all of it, when you understand that when he who sits on the throne and the Lamb calls the realms to order and opens up the books and look and see whose name is written and not written, and when he sentences them by the power of his word, you come to understand that God is in control and that we are going to overcome. Matter of factly, hallelujah, in eternal time we have already overcome, just in the same way like the Lamb was slain from before the foundations of the world. We have already overcome, even though time has not met us there yet. Come on, beat your chest like a radical and say, I am in the number. Oh, come on, you can't do it unless you believe, you know. You got to know that you know that you know that you know that you are an overcomer. Hello, somebody. I am more than a conqueror. I am among them that are robed in white. I say, I've got my name on a stone and I've got a mansion with my name on it. This is not prophecy. This is declaring what is. Now, one of the absolute truths that the revelations bring about is that the will of God in the entire narrative of the plan of God must be done. The will of God is not a maybe thing. It's not a might thing. God ain't making suggestions. What God has willed, it has to come to pass. Oh, Chateau, I feel the temperature rising. Whether it is at the beginning or the middle or the very end, the will of God must be done. For who hath stood in the counsel of the Lord, Jeremiah 23:18, and hath perceived and heard his word? Who hath marked his words and has heard it? Now notice the validation of this. Behold, a whirlwind of the Lord is gone forth in fury, even a grievous whirlwind. It shall fall grievously upon the head of the wicked. The anger of the Lord shall not return until he has executed, until he have performed the thoughts of his heart. In the latter days you shall consider it perfectly. God shall judge the earth. God shall bring demonic potentates to answer for their actions. Some of you are not sure that you believe it, but it is so. I don't care what their names are. It doesn't care which section of the quadrants of heaven they once belonged to. The master is going to call them to order. For he is the only article, all time, indisputable, quintessential, God Almighty. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody give the Lord a praise. For my thoughts, talking about the will of God, neither are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways. Isaiah 55:9, saith the Lord, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it to bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereunto I sent it. If God says, if you believe in me, you shall have whatsoever you ask. I don't care which demon, it don't matter which jagabat, I don't care which bloom fryer, hallelujah, says otherwise. If God said you're blessed, hallelujah, even if you don't know it, you are blessed. If God says you're healed, it no matter what your pancreas say, if God say you are healed, you are healed. The will of God cannot be thwarted, aborted, revised, amen, amended, hallelujah, ratified. It cannot be in any way questioned. The will of God is declared from his mouth, and it is absolutely fixed in the eternals, amen. Some of us came in here tonight, and we are wondering, what are we going to get from the last night? God has prepared something for you, hallelujah, and as the word is going forth, if you can focus your mind on what God is speaking into your spirit, it will leave the realm of the invisible, and it will come into your realm, because God said so. Amen. Ephesians 1:11 says, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will, that we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ. God's word ain't gonna change. Hello? One last scripture concerning that. Hallelujah. We are in, God willing, more abundantly to show to the ears of promise, Hebrews 6:17, the immutability of his counsel. Confirm that counsel by an oath, that by two immutable things, number one, that once God says it, it cannot go back, and number two, that whatever God wills will never change. It was in which it was impossible for God to lie. We might have strong consolation, who have fled for refuge, to lay hold upon the hope set before us, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, and which entereth into that within the veil. The will of God will never change, and it must be done. Hello? Considering that God has a plan from eternity past to eternity to come, and in time, God has a plan for you. Every one of us is purposefully made true. God designed us to come out of sin into salvation through the power of his name, through faith in his name, amen, through the application of his blood that somehow is mysteriously translated in the watery baptism, I believe by the enunciation and the pronouncement of the name of Jesus, amen. That is the will of God. That is an expression of the will of God in our time. Stay with me here, praise God, amen. God wants to tell us something, amen. Considering that the will of God will never change, considering also that we have only around 70 years, I don't know, Bishop Clark's brother has 10 years left on his usual lease, and is only the strength of God that will see him beyond 70. And don't start looking at him crooked. All of us that are alive, if you're not there yet and you live long enough, you will get there. You only have 70 years and 10. I mean, you could even glow in the dark because of how anointed you are. You're gone dead. Hallelujah. I know some of us are stush that we think, hallelujah, God can't kill me, but you're gonna die. You could look like the princess of Egypt. You're gonna rotten and you're gonna stink. Oh yes. Ah, God, it don't matter what kind of perfume you wear and what kind of food you eat, you are going to die. So the will of God can't change. You don't know how long you have left. What you surely know is that you don't have more than 100 years. Mama Hushbabakita. This weekend we understand things about the kingdom of God. We looked into kingdom authority. We looked into kingdom worship. We look into kingdom holiness. We have analyzed and assessed the present darkness that is over our city and that is over our world. God gave us insight that is peculiar, unusual revelation as the man of God stood before us and spoke, amen, concerning the nations of the world. We got an inside view into a world that only God could have arranged, considering the signs that are around us. Looking at the times, we must discern. It is not just the breaking of the day. I believe it's the last couple of seconds, hallelujah, before the heavens roll back like a scroll. It is an any minute now thing. Oh Lord God, I wish we would get it. We have got to come to the place now that we get to commitment. We have got to redeem the times, understand the seasons. We have got to learn the mandate of God that is in effect and the demonic mandate that is in effect over the earth. Hello somebody, it's not time to live on elementary level understanding. It's the time to up your game. It's the time to up your anointing. It's the time to up your level of living. It's the time to increase your commitment to God. It is time to identify the challenge and systems that support and operate challenges in your life. You got to identify who you are, because the devil fights us at the level of our anointing and not by necessarily what we are called in church. If you are anointed as an apostle, even if you're living at the level of a deacon, the devil is fighting you at the level of an apostle.
Yes, sir.
He fights you by rank. Okay, I've got to move on. So much to say and so little time. We've got to systematically address the challenges that face us using the tools of the kingdom of God available to us. We have got to exercise faith unto life, even through death. You've got to utilize your anointing to completely resist the devil. Never compromise. Something that God wants me to say here tonight is that we have been positioned to prevail, and we must now get into mental position in order that we might prevail. And there is only one way to do this. In the end time, I don't know why some of us want to live in the tribulation period. I hope by God, hallelujah, that the rapture is before the trib. I believe it is before the trib. Hallelujah. I don't know who is waiting for the tribulation period, but you can keep my house and the car. Amen. The rest of the clothes and everything my wife leave behind. You can have the leftover chicken in the fridge. Hallelujah. And the Chinese food on the table. And the bakush. But as for me and my house, I want to be gone. I don't want to be here. It's a time such as never was. A time that you'll never be seen again. Ah, God. If in under the abundance of grace, we find it so hard to make it, what about when God pulls it from the realm? Shama Mandi Koshebe Hesunduru Ramakatura Shaka. Hallelujah. It is time to commit. And the type of commitment is an absolute commitment. Worship the Lord thy God with all of thine heart, with all of thy soul, with all of thy might, with all of thy strength, and thy neighbor as yourself. The time for half measures is done. The time for half in and half out is over. The Lord brought me back to Shushan in the time of Esther, when the Hamanite conspiracy was to kill all of Israel. Stay with me, I won't be much longer. Notice, in this Shushanite conspiracy, look at the demonic systems. Number one, it was a time of great backsliding. They were under punishment, remember? They were told to go back to rebuild by Cyrus, yeah? And some of them stayed. They should have gone, but they stayed. Right? Help me if my homiletics or my something is off. Huh? Notice now, Haman took objection to Brother Mordecai.
Because every knee shall bow and every tongue confess. Old Testament would be that Yahweh is Lord. Yah is Lord. Yah is Lord. He will rise from the dead because he's Lord. You know, kind of see with me, praise the Lord. Hang with me here. Mordecai understood, I ain't going to bow to you, boy, because I've got royalty in my blood. And God says I mustn't bow to any demon and beg any devil. You could be Mr. Pumpy in your pumpkin with your rat horses. I ain't going to bow to you. I know who I am. I'm a child of the great God. I should not make homage to nobody, including you. So you will never get me bow, boy. Haman didn't like it. We know the story. Notice though, we are all guilty by bloodline. He hated Mordecai. It translated to a hate for the entire nation of Israel. So even those that were not at Shushan were also going to be exterminated. Everybody's in trouble. I wonder if you see that. It wasn't the Shushanites alone. It was everybody, those who had gone back to rebuild. Everybody else, or the whole gang, all of them were in trouble. It is what is called an existential crisis. If Haman had succeeded, the entire nationality of the Hebrews would have been obliterated. You see why we can't sit down and play anky panky? You think the devil, because he's not up in your backyard, he's not trying to cut you off remotely? You think because you're not seeing any war right now, it means you're not under war? He's fighting gatekeepers. He's fighting the apostles. He's resisting the bishops. He's coming against the men and the women of God that will lead the charge until you rise up and walk. But you're not feeling it yet, maybe because of your distance to where the head of the battle is. I got to move. The totality of our commitment is underscored even from that time, where Esther realized that she had to put her life on the line. God is saying to us here tonight that I am not looking for a part of your life. I am not interested only in one aspect of your ministry. I want all of you. I want every part. Because the level that I want to take the church, and the level to which the church is going to go in the latter day, if you have 1/2 mile given to the devil, you are going to get in trouble. Because the battle is going to get so hot that only those that are dead in Christ can successfully resist the devil. I wish I had a church. The commitment has got to reach such a crescendo that you're not partying with some of the world and then have some of the God in your back pocket. It ain't gonna work. If you've got a credit card for the devil to meet him at Starbucks after church, God said, take out the credit card, carry it to the altar, and crush it under the blood. Because I need all of you. I need all of you. Because of the times, because of the season in which you live, you got to get rid of mediocrity. You got to get rid of half measures. You got to quit playing anky panky and really get serious with God. Jesus, look at somebody and tell him it's an absolute commitment. It is validated by revelations. You notice, as an addendum to how they overcome, blood and testimony, the attitude or the level of commitment of the believer is underscored by this one little phrase, and counted not their lives dear unto that. That means they were absolutely committed.
I see two evidences of this in Old Testament again. Number one, brother Joseph. Joseph had a bone determination not to stay in Egypt. Joseph says, even if I die, baby, take my bones out of here, because I know that we're going to leave. I might not see it, but I know he was committed to the bones. I see the eye of God peering down in the corridors of some people's soul right here tonight. I see him walking down the corridors of your body. I see him knocking at closed doors. Partial commitment. You used to fast and pray. You used to take holiday. And 3 days out of your vacation was just for you and Jesus. Hallelujah. But you're backed up on your commitment. I know it's getting, when it's getting raunchy, you know that the Holy Ghost is pumping. I feel God pressing his sword in some dark areas in some people's lives. Some of us want to be saved. We want Jesus. We want Holy Ghost. But we have other occupants on the inside. God will not put, hallelujah, his precious Holy Ghost where there are other idols bowing down. It's either they bow down or they get out. I wonder if you're hearing what I'm saying. God says, you've got to commit, all of you. The other guys that were absolutely committed were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They say, if we die, we die. But we refuse to bow because we are absolutely sold out. The Holy Ghost is talking to ministers. The Holy Ghost is talking to choristers. The Holy Ghost is talking to everybody in here. We've got to raise the level of our sacrosance. We've got to raise the level of our internal holiness. I'm not talking about the apparent holiness. I'm talking about the real holiness. Not just the holiness as a function of sanctification, which is averse, amen, to corruption. Not that kind of holiness alone. I'm talking about the absolute holiness where you're so sold out, baby, that you can't watch certain things simply and purely, because it's antagonistic to the kingdom manifesto. You can't go certain places, honey, and because of your absolute commitment to God, you can't talk a certain way, sweetie, because your lips have been anointed to release life. You can't behave in certain ways because you're absolutely set apart and set aside unto God. I've got to move on. The Bible says in Romans 8, I'm almost stopped. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. Hang with me for a little more. Mabaushi. Remakoto Shebe. God is saying it's time for you to trade me the uncommitted areas in your life for absolute glory. I want to deal with one law in real estate here, right now. There was a law known as equal access. Some of you might be familiar with it. Where if there's 100 acres of land, for argument's sake, and one person owns 1 acre smack dab in the middle of the other person's 99, the person that has the 99 acreage of land has to allow at least one 24-hour access point to that one little incy-wincy acre in the middle of his 99. Geometrically and arithmetically, the road will end up being more than a mile. So he has to give up more than what you have, that you can come to the little that you have. Search me, oh God, and know my heart, I pray. Try me. Don't get nervous. Dear Savior, know my thoughts, I pray. See
some wicked ways in me and cleanse me from every sin and set me free.
You see, because of what is called parallax, because of our limitation in visual field, we can be staring at something and still don't see it. That's why we need God to search us. Anything that you permit, you are most likely to be blinded to see it for what it really is. I slow down just for this. So you ever wonder why? You can preach at the highest level. You can heal at the deepest measure. And right after that, the devil barges through all of your anointing.
Hallelujah.
No. Steps right into your house and sit down in a certain area of your life. He has access. Anything that's under darkness is under the legal tender of the devil. I say, I feel heaven open for each. Hallelujah. The law of equal. God is a God of order. He respects covenant. He respects his own rules. We have some areas in our lives, women of God, that we will not allow any light to shine in. We call them all kind of things. We call them strongholds, footholds. We call them bondage points. We call them fortresses. But what they really are territories that have been sanctified unto the devil. Let it soak. Our little pet sin. I'm not telling you anything that I haven't walked through. And still ask God to search. When David says, search me, O God. Keep back thy servant from presumptuous sins. Hello, somebody. There are some areas of darkness in our lives. Anywhere where anytime the word of God comes and begins to show you, you immediately have an automatic response to deflect. Whoosh. Somehow invalidate what the word is saying. Yeah, man, watch it. Anytime the Lord starts to touch that area in your life, you'll find that all the arsenals go up to shoot down the word of God to say, not me, it's not me. It's the devil's territory. That's why some people can speak in 17 languages on Sunday night, and by Monday morning they're in the devil's bar sipping his pina colada. And I'm telling you, it ain't virgin. It is mixed up from the mother of prostitutes, sister mother Babylon the Great. Hallelujah. And you just delivered 5 million people last year, but there is an area of darkness. I feel somebody getting serious and saying, I've had enough. I'm gonna tell this dark spot, you got to go. I'm gonna apply the blood. Mama Shia, Reketoro Shibahaya, Mandio Shia. If it is not you, then it's all right. But if you know there is an area of darkness, turn on the light. Turn on the light. Come on, I want you to do it now. God said, do it now. Open up your mouth. Confess the area. Tell God the GPS. Hallelujah. Lord, turn on your searchlight. Hallelujah. I'm leaving kingdom focus. Hallelujah. Absolutely committed. No area of darkness. That's what the unsaved does when they come to God.
When they repent, they just open themselves and say, Lord, here I am. I'm totally dark. I need the light of your word. Father, forgive me, for I have sinned. You want the Holy Ghost? Make a total repentance. Amen. Make an absolute commitment. And I tell you, you don't need an altar to get the Holy Ghost. Right in your seat, as you open up your heart and confess Jesus Christ, and the light shines in, and the darkness is repelled, you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Two more things.
So the church, moments before the rapture and the wrath of God, the church faces satanic disintegration programs. Smitten shepherds scatter sheep, disenfranchise the reinforcement personnel, and create gift drain. Gift centrism, see with me, has been lost at the expense of talent manifestation. We promote people by gift and degrees more, by talent and degrees more than spiritual gifts. You don't have to say amen. It doesn't change the fact that it is true. What the devil does is silence the gifts, because he can't handle the spiritual gifts. He can deal with your PhD. He can deal with your master's in human resource management. He can deal with your MBA very quickly. Hello. But when you're red hot and absolutely committed, and you're functioning even with your one-shot gift, hallelujah, when you angle that spiritual bazooka and ruko shuko him, he knows he can't handle it, because it's not your degree that he's facing. He's facing the unmitigated power of the mighty God. Somebody praise the Lord. I need my gift. The devil creates gift drain, where the gifted people are sitting in church and they are not utilizing their gifts. And the church walks when it should run. The church runs when it should fly. The church flies when it should jump and leapfrog through time. The other thing that happens, you have a disorientation of the Joshua generation and create what is called generational abortion. I've seen it in a lot of churches, a lot of assemblies, where between ages 17 and 30, the entire generation is gone, with the exception of one or two. Well, you don't want to say it's true, it's so. I'll soon take my seat. Don't worry. I'm not running out of what to say. Hallelujah. I am not. The Holy Ghost is talking in my spirit. You ever wonder what's going on? It is a disorientation of the Joshua generation.
Why?
So Joshua is not allowed to exercise his anointing under the weight of his daddy Moses sitting up high. And all Moses needs to do is lift a hand. But Joshua better fight blood and bone. Oh God, I wish I had a church. And all Moses does at his level is just lift his hand. I know what I'm talking about. I got to preach for 50 minutes. But my seniors up here talk for 15 minutes. And what God does after their 15 minutes, I need to pray and fast for 5 years to get to that level. Yes, you don't want to say amen, sit down and shut up and see if the bench don't start talking beneath you. And you will know it ain't your gluteus maximus speaking to your minimus. It will be God rebuking you. There has been a disorientation of the Joshua generation, where for lack of visionary leadership, Joshua is not allowed to command the son to stand still in the witness of his daddy Moses. Why? Why? Somebody say why.
Why?
One more time, why?
Why?
One last why?
Why?
Joshua in the valley, Moses, just lift up your hand. Just lift up your hand. And the anointing will flow on Joshua. Moses, just raise your hand. Why? Jesus, have mercy. You better give God thanks that you have a wise and a sensible Moses up here. You better give God thanks to him and his wife and family and pray them through in the Holy Ghost. I don't have time. What do we do here? Like Sister Esther, we have a choice. Do we hide from our reality and perish suddenly and certainly? Because if Esther had significantly disobeyed, yes, I believe God would have raised up, hallelujah, help from some places like Mordecai said, but she would have died and her entire family would have died, but Israel would have been saved. In this time, in this hour, young woman of God, it don't matter how young you are, soldier, God is looking for absolute commitment, and you're gonna have to make a choice. I go all the way with Jesus, or I go all the way with the devil. There is no middle ground. There is nothing between zero and one. Hallelujah. Numerically, holistically, hallelujah, you have zero and one. You're either in or you're out. Somebody here is making up their mind right now. Somebody here is parting with some stuff right now. Somebody's giving up some idols right now. Jesus, I've got to be finished. I've got to stop. Divine favor has platformed us for this moment. Notice what could have happened to Esther. Uncertainty. This is inspiration that flowed from the other night about faith. Uncertainty breeds either faith or doubt. Yeah? When you're looking at an uncertain thing, you either experience a lift in faith or a sink in doubt. Hushma. Sefra kushku. Doubt breeds fear. Fear embraces safety. Stay with me, man. Buy the tape and play it over. Safety imposes limitations. Stay with me. But faith embraces absolute certainties. You know what we are absolutely certain about? We win the war. You know what we are absolutely certain about? Only one God is sitting on the throne in Revelation. You know what we are absolutely certain about? God will never change his word, and his will never be altered. You know what we are certain about? It don't matter what kind of form the devil takes, those that know the name of the Lord their God shall walk strong and do exploits. Somebody begin to praise God. Jesus Christ. I want us all to stand. This is the point where we have to stand. Faith in the absolute truths of God, once mobilized, is unstoppable. Faith in the absolute truths of God facilitate a connection that is unusual, holistic, world-changing. Faith in the absolute certainties of God will create access to all relevant levels of spiritual authority. Faith in the absolute things of God exposes the diabolic wiles of the arch enemy, and it facilitates the fulfillment of the will of God generationally. Destroy every anti-commitment in your spirit right here, right now. And as you having done that and you're getting ready, you will realize that there is a different level of connection. Because when your spirit gives God more room to have traction, the pull, mother, becomes more significant. If somebody is dropping off a cliff, you don't throw them a finger, you throw them a hand, which is a compendium of five fingers. When you give up unto God all of you, that means God will possess you totally and absolutely. Absolute commitment guarantees absolute connection. The connection is facilitated by the Holy Ghost. God who sees the heart gives the Holy Ghost. And God who sees the heart gives you more of faith to overcome. Oh, all right. All right. All right. The landscape is set. The end of the battle, we know. The time we are living in, we know. The state of our lives, we know. What God is requiring, we now know. What we have in our possession, we better know. You've got power. Hallelujah. And we're going to come to the next level. And I'm going to hand off this mic to my senior in the Lord. And when you commit, and after you commit to God, I mean, you give up everything. I'm serious. The Holy Ghost wants me to stay there. I mean, an absolute commitment. You used to watch a little something, something that you're not supposed to watch. Watch. God says, burn up the DVD, but I paid $24.99. God say you wasted your money. Get over it. Hallelujah. You spend certain nights doing certain things. God say you need to cut it off, because I need you in the chamber. Hallelujah. But God, I got to spend time with boo. God say I go and boo you anyhow. You know, come talk to me. Am I in the right place here tonight? God is searching in our hearts. He's saying you've given time for everything, and I want more of you. I've got stuff to show. I've got stuff to show you. I've got stuff to carry you to. Ah, but I need you to get rid of Sister Jezebel. I need you to get in the moon. I need you to put down the wine of Babylon. I need you to smash the glass. Shanda Baba Katasa. I need you to connect to me and let me download the cleaner program inside of you. Somebody in here is about to experience a reset of the Holy Ghost. You're about to experience God stepping inside of your heart and clearing out the quagmire and setting you up for a breakout. Ah, Jesus, are you at the place? Are you looking at the spots in your life? Are you ready for it? Let me hear you respond. Let me hear you respond. Let me hear you respond. I commit, I commit, I commit. I commit, I commit, I commit. I sell out every land that belongs to the devil, every practice that is anti-God, every behaviorism that gives the devil room. I'm a child of God. I'm purposely made. I'm designed to travel in the heavens. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody give the Lord praise right now. Lift up holy hands in the sanctuary. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Bishop Clark, at this time, as you lift up your hands and bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Come, sir. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, lift your hands, everybody. Come on, lift your hands, everybody. Come on, lift your hands, everybody. I know that there are folks here who believe in themselves. I know that there are folks here who believe in their money. I know that there are folks here who believe in their friends. They believe in what they have. They are sure of where they're going when they leave here tonight. But I want to ask those who believe that God can do what he said he will do. Let me see you by the raise of your hands. I was telling the church today that, and Sister Clark need to know it, just touch the monitor up a little bit. I've been preaching for quite a while, and I want to make this altar call in a few minutes and move. Just touch me up. Hallelujah. I was telling the church and telling Sister Clark that if I happen to leave Grand Cayman and a casket come back home, if that be the case, because I booked for the fourth rapture, you know, to join Elijah Enoch. Are you with me? Are you with me, choir? I plan to join Elijah, Enoch, and Jesus. I don't mean the final rapture, that big rapture. I mean, anything can happen anytime. But if I have to go in the casket, I wouldn't tell God what to do. Come on, somebody. And so I say, if I leave the house, Sister Clark, don't you ever think I must come back the
allow
way
the
I
Lord
left.
To use
it could
him.
Be that the carcass come back and the kill,
and
the flesh, and the spirit
all,
step out. You see, what it means, it's that I am really ready. Somebody say, I'm ready. And you don't say you're ready Sunday night and tomorrow morning, it's a different thing. If you are ready, you are ready. Come on, somebody. I want everyone to stand to your feet right now. If you have foot, stand on it. If you don't have any, excuse me. But those who can stand, I want you to stand right now as we're about to bring the service to its close. Just lift your hands if you need something from the Lord. Hallelujah. I sense something happening in the atmosphere. The next thing that I'd like to ask right now, it's that the people who doesn't believe in God, you, it's not an insult, but I'd like to ask you to take up your purses and your bags and go through the doors. And you could stand out there and eat Kisco and popcorn until we are closing here. You can come back. Because you see, the spirit of unbelief is the lack of faith is the root of all evil. And Jesus was God, Minister Millwood, and he couldn't handle it. Well, Bishop Thomas, when Jesus went to a place to raise a dead girl, he saw the people, they came, but he recognized that they were so doubtful that they would hinder even God in the person of Jesus Christ from raising the dead. And so Jesus said, it's not an insult, but you go, come Peter, come James, and come John. And I see some of you come wondering what God is going to do. I can see it on your face, because you don't pray, you don't fast, you don't know God, and yet I don't want to trouble anybody, it's an altar call, but all those who believe in God, slip your hand up right now. If you believe in God, slip your hand up right now. We have been into South Africa, Ethiopia, and I've seen in one service over 64,000 people received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Don't tell me we can't receive the Holy Ghost in our tens and twenties and hundreds. Don't tell me that people, don't get scared in here now. I know you operate by faith. Some of you operate by your degree, but we believe that the church operates by faith. So anything you think and God said he can do, you are ready for it. So for the next 5 minutes, you see somebody beside you, they look tush and stiff, and they don't want to be troubled. Tell them, excuse me, you could go through the door until we finish our altar call. You can come back. It's not an insult, but I believe somebody needs to be baptized in Jesus' name right now. Somebody stir the pool. Somebody stir the water. Stir the water. Stir the, if you believe, stir the water. Stir. Somebody says stir. Somebody says stir. Somebody says stir. Somebody says stir. I feel my faith rising now. Somebody says stir. The water is troubled. Ooh, shut up. My God Almighty. Sometimes, Bishop Thomas, you go into some areas and you see so much doctor, this doctor, that doctor. Everybody is a doctor and the whole church is dying. Can I speak as I'm led? To make this altar call right now. You see, sometimes we need to believe God. Now we have some generals that are here. I want all the deacons and pastors and bishops and ministers and evangelists to slip your hand up right now that you believe God, that in this house somebody is going to get delivered. Somebody is going to get delivered. Somebody is going to step out of time into eternity in the next 2 minutes. Come on generals. I want to see the generals standing up. Look here, folks. Look here. Don't let the kingdom of this world fool you. God is the head. God is the head. The Holy Ghost is the head. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. We go to Mandela's house and the answer wasn't there. Bishop, we go into the Buckingham Palace. The answer wasn't there. We go into the Vatican Palace and the answer wasn't there. Come on, somebody. The answer is at the cross. And once you come to the cross, something good. I still feel some doubtful religious people troubling me head up in here. Turn around and ask the person beside you, do you believe? I'm clearing the air right now, because if Jesus couldn't get the altar call done by doubters being close, then how can I make an altar call with doubtful people around? Ask somebody, do you believe? Somebody shout, yes, I believe that God can turn my... Oh, God. Yes. Listen. I'm not a pucker, but I'm going to ask somebody to turn around. Just turn, because some stush people who don't think they can raise their hand, don't think they can turn in church, don't think they can say hallelujah in church,
Somebody said, turn. Turn from your coldness. Turn from your deadness. God wants to give somebody a breakthrough right now. Shut up. Somebody said, turn one more time. I'm turning from sickness to healing. I'm turning from death to life. Like a shut up. Tell somebody, turn. Ooh, shut up. My God Almighty. Then you must understand that God didn't give gifts to men. He gave the gifts to the church to pull you out of darkness. For no demons, no witch, no warlock can stop a bishop that God called. And that's why your bishop is floating. No demons can stop a pastor. No demons can stop Holy Ghost choir leader. No demons can put their finger on the musician. Come on, somebody. Somebody open your mouth and shout, Holy Ghost. Let a church of Holy Ghost. Let a church of Holy Ghost. So right at the spine pointing of time, you have heard the word through the servant of God, and you believe God. Nobody can stop you from walking into your miracle. I'd like to see the hands raised. Those who have not yet been baptized in the Holy Ghost, not yet filled with the Holy Ghost, slip your hand quickly. My God Almighty. Come on, quickly, slip your hands up. You have not yet been filled with the Holy Ghost. Please come over to my left. The generals are here. And all the generals believe tonight. I don't see no one to see no generals running through the side door. The devil is a liar. It is the generals who's going to say, somebody's going to get the Holy Ghost. Somebody's going to get delivered. Come on, somebody. It is the ministers who are going to stand up and believe with you tonight for your breakthrough. I like to see the hands of those who need a breakthrough tonight. Come on, raise your hands. Keep coming now. Step out of your seat. Rashata. Come on, quickly. I've gone 2.5 minutes already. I'm looking at a 5-minute period to make this altar call. Come on. I'd like to ask all the young people, teenagers from 4 upward, to start marching down the altar. Come on, musician, I want to hear you trackling in the Holy Ghost over there. Come on. In heaven, there is a choir that play when Jesus is getting the work done. Even when he was creating the heaven and the earth, the Bible said the morning star song. Let the singers and the praisers get ready now, for somebody's about to get delivered. All the backsliders, you heard the word tonight. Let me see the backsliders coming back. Where are the generals? Where are the bishops, the ministers? You're going to stand up in faith tonight and see God touch somebody. See God deliver somebody. All the young people, come over. All the young people, get them right in here. We can't sit down and watch our young people go through colleges and universities and go to the Hollywood. Come on. All the young people, send them over here. God said, I want to touch you right now. He said, I want to empower you now. He said, I want to deliver you right now. Come right now. Come on now. Those who need a miracle, those who need a breakthrough, raise your hands. You need a breakthrough right now from God. Come on, don't be afraid to step over here. Squeeze your way through and come down here right now. Come on, squeeze your way through and come down here right now. Come on. We're not going to be scared to say hallelujah. We're not going to be afraid to say thank you, Jesus. We're not going to be afraid to say, Lord, I want to be baptized in water in your name. Somebody else down there, you need to come down here. God wants to take you to another level. Come on, step out, young people. Step out, young woman. Come on. Clear the eyes. Clear the eyes. Somebody needs a breakthrough right now. Get ready, choir. Get ready. The generals are laying hands already. I said the generals are already laying hands on you. Rabaka Shaka. Something is about to break out. The choir is ready. The musicians are ready. The bishop is ready. Come on, somebody. I see demons backing up now. Warlocks and witches are running through the door. The blood is released right now. Somebody said the blood. Blood, 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 blood. Open your mouth. The blood of Jesus is working on the case right now. Jesus is setting somebody free. The heavens are open right now. Yes. Get up off your feet. Get up off your feet. Come over here. Come over here. God said, I want you to walk the aisle right now. There is a blessing for somebody. Come on down. Come on down. Keep coming. You are standing too still. Move for your miracle. Move for your breakthrough. 4 minutes are gone. Rabba Shaka. I have 1 minute left to call you. 1 minute left. Rabba Shaka. Yes. God cannot kill dumb people. You've got to open your mouth to be full of the Holy Ghost. You've got to swallow all pride. The church is about to take off. You've got to open your mouth. Come on. Lay your hands on them right now. Somebody shout yes, Lord. Shout yes, Lord. Come over here. Yes. A breakthrough is here for you. I said a breakthrough is here for you. Oh, yes. Yes. Let the church of Holy Ghost. Somebody shout Holy Ghost. Let the church of Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. Open your mouth now. Your breakthrough is right here. Yes, young girl, open your mouth. Yes, sir. Open your mouth. The devil is afraid when you open your mouth and begin to thank God for your miracle. Yes, it's here. Somebody need help. You're in the back. The Lord is calling you to come down in the altar. Don't leave until you get down here tonight. Yes. 5 minutes is gone. He said, I'm ready to bless you. I'm ready to deliver you. I'm ready to set you free. Yes. Open your mouth, little boy. Yes, sir. It's your time. Let the Holy Ghost in. Lay hands on somebody right now. Yes, lay your hands on somebody. It's your night for a breakthrough. Breakthrough. The blood is on the case. The blood is working it out now. The blood is powerful. The blood of Jesus is released. Come on, take your breakthrough now. Yes. Open your mouth. That's the Holy Ghost. Yes. Ooh, shut up. Yes. Open your mouth. Yes, the Holy Ghost is here. Ooh, rabba. Altar workers. Open your mouth. Lay your hands if you believe God on them and tell them. Tell them to receive the Holy Ghost. They're going to get the Holy Ghost in your hands tonight for the first time. Come on, lay your hands on them right now. Rabba kataya. Out of your belly. Little boy, receive the Holy Ghost. In the last day, said God, I will pour on my spirit upon all flesh. Somebody say all flesh. Black flesh, white flesh, young flesh, old flesh. Holy Ghost, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Rababoko Shakaba. My God Almighty. Somebody open your mouth over here. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Tell them to receive the Holy Ghost. Some of you need a double portion. You haven't spoken in tongues in years. You need a double portion. A fresh touch. Rabba Sakaya.
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. Yes. Open your mouth. 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 Holy Ghost is in here. Holy Ghost is in here. Holy Ghost is in here. Yes. 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 They're getting ready to speak in tongues now. They're getting ready to speak in tongues. Young boys getting ready to speak in tongues. Young girls getting ready to speak in tongues. They are getting ready to speak in tongues right now. Rabakota. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth now. Rabasa. Open your mouth. Receive the Holy Ghost. Yes. 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 That's the Holy Ghost. That's the Holy Ghost. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes. Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop. No holding back. Receive. Receive power. Receive the anointing. Receive the Holy Ghost. Come on, everybody. Open your mouth. Receive the Holy Ghost now. Yes. 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 Open your mouth now. Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. My God Almighty, my God Almighty. Yes, the Holy Ghost is here. Open him out. Open him out. Open him out. Come, Bishop. Open him out now. Open him out. Open him out. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. If you are feeling the Holy Ghost down there, come up here. If you are not feeling the Holy Ghost, come down. Rabakashaka. Yes. Yes. Something is happening. Something is happening. Something is happening. Something is happening. Get your hands on somebody. Get your hands on somebody. Tell them to receive the Holy Ghost. Rashatama. My God, my God, my God. Yes. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here. Ooh, Shabba. He's here. He's here. Repent and receive it now. Repent and receive it now. Come on, if you repent, God will forgive you and fill you right now. Repent and receive the Holy Ghost now. Tell him to forgive you and receive the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. The blood is good. The blood is rich. The blood is strong. Yes. Rabba Shata. Yeah, yeah, man. You've got to get the Holy Ghost. You've got to get the Holy Ghost. You've got to get the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth, woman. Open your mouth. Yes. 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 Don't stop praising him now. Come on, don't stop praising him. Don't stop praising him. It's a rapture. It's a rapture certificate. The Holy Ghost is your rapture certificate. You're going to get that visa tonight. Somebody's going to get that visa tonight. Open your mouth now. Rashatama. Yes, yes, yes. Little boy, praise the Lord. Little girl, praise the Lord. Young girl, praise the Lord. Young boy, praise the Lord. Praise your way through to the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. Rabasaka. Come on, lay your hands of faith on them right now. And tell them to receive the Holy Ghost. Lay your hands of faith on them right now. And tell them to receive the Holy Ghost. Yes. Yes, the Holy Ghost is here. Yes, the Holy Ghost is here. Rashata. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes. The Holy Ghost is moving. God is healing your body. God is healing your mind. That's the Holy Ghost. That's the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. I said, God is healing your mind. Rakashatama. Holy Ghost is here. Yes. Shababa. Shababa. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Rakashatama. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Open your mouth, Holy Ghost, power now. That's the Holy Ghost. That's the Holy Ghost, come on somebody. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Holy Ghost power. Holy Ghost power is here. Somebody open your mouth. Somebody got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, but shut up. They're getting the Holy Ghost. They're getting power is on you. I heard you speaking. Release it now. Release it now. Power is on you. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Rabba Sata Koshayaba. Rabba Sata. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth now. Open your mouth now. Yes, 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 yes. It's your night. Open your mouth. Rabba Boshatama. To receive the Maka Shata. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Power, power. Receive, 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 receive. Oh, Shama. Yes. 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 Fresh anointing, fresh anointing. Rabakashata. Yes, 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 yes. Open your mouth. Open. Ah. That's the Holy Ghost. That's the Holy Ghost. Come on. Yes, yes, yes. That's the Holy Ghost. That's the Holy Ghost. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. That's the Holy Ghost. Speak it out. Open your mouth. 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 Yes, receive the power. Receive the power. Receive the power. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. With stammering lips and in other tongues, will he speak to you right now? Open your mouth and thank him for the Holy Ghost. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Tell him to receive the Holy Ghost. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Receive the Holy Ghost. Yes, yes. Open your mouth. Power, 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 power.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Power now, open your mouth. Yes, yes, Katashaya. Yes, Holy Ghost is falling. Holy Ghost is falling now. My God, my God, my God. Open your mouth.
Yes, yes, it's your night, it's your night. Your breakthrough here, open your mouth.
Yes, yes, yes. 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 Yes, yes, yes. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Mashata. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive. Yes, yes.
Jesus. Jesus.
Yes, yes. Open your mouth. Rababosha. Yes, 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 yes. 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 Raboshatama. Open your mouth. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship now. The power is on you. The power is on you. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
yes, yes. Yes. Yes, yes, that. Yes, yes, yes. Let the church of Holy Ghost. Power is on you now. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. The power is on you now. It's your night. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Yes, somebody shout yes. Somebody shout yes to the Holy Ghost. Shout yes, Holy Ghost. Work, Holy Ghost. Rashatama. Out of your belly shall flow. Yes, 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 yes. Ooh, shut up. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Open your mouth, the power is on you. The power is on you now, the power is on you. Open your mouth. Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes, yes. Out of your belly, out of your belly. Out of your belly. Rabaka shaka. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Ooh, shanama. Yes, yes, yes. Holy Ghost. Ooh, shatama. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Power now. Fresh. Fresh anointing. Fresh. 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 Yes. Yes. I'd like to ask everyone to stand in the building right now. Before we pray the closing prayer, everybody stand right now. Stand to your feet. The Holy Ghost is in this place. Just come down a little closer to the altar. There is a fire in here. There is a power in here. Just come down a little closer. Take 2 more minutes before we pray the closing prayer. Somebody open up your mouth right now. Come on, shout out to God with a voice of triumph. 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah. Shout. Receive. Receive the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. Shout out. You must open your mouth. You must open your mouth. You must speak in tongues. You must open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Shut up. Yes. Yes. The anointing is on you. 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 The anointing is on you now. I said the anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. Yes, it's on you. Yes. Power is on you. Fire is on you. Glory is on you. Open your mouth. The anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. Power is on you. Fire is on you. Open your mouth. Yes, it's on you. Yes. Open your mouth. Shaka. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Come on, open your mouth. It's your night for a breakthrough. Open your mouth. Now. Yes, open your mouth. Come on, thank him for the kushama. Shatama. Come on, just worship the Lord for 2 more minutes. I know you've been coming for a long convocational period, but come on down, give God 2 more sensible minutes. He's going to cover you up for the ending of the week, over the coming week. Come on, stand to your feet. Give the Lord 2 more minutes of worship. When the praise goes up, the blessings will come down. Come on. Give him 2 more minutes of praise in the house. Yes. Come on, give him 2 more minutes of praise in the house. Real Holy Ghost praise in the house. Yes, yes, yes. 2 minutes of real Holy Ghost. Real Holy Ghost praise in the house. Somebody's going to get a breakthrough now. Holy Ghost is on you. Holy Ghost is on you. Holy Ghost is on you. Rabakashata. It's your moment. It's your hour. It's your day. It's your time. Yes. Open your mouth. Rashata maha. Oh, my God Almighty, I feel the anointing in here. Yes, 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 yes. 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 Come on, step over your chair and come up 2 more inches. Come on, come on. Step over your chair for your grandson. For that druggist in the family, step over your chair. Come a little further for your backside husband. For somebody to get a breakthrough right in this house. Come on, I know you have a long way to drive. But step over here for 2 more minutes. Come on, let's go. Shut up. Yes. Tell them to receive the Holy Ghost. Allah, shut up. We're taking only 10 minutes. It took them 10 days in the upper room. Rabakosha. Yes, we're taking only 10 to 15 minutes. It took them 10 days in the upper room. Come on, open your mouth and tell the Lord. Rabasata. Shut up. God's going to double up now. He's going to double up the anointing on you now. Open your mouth. Yes, 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 yes. Hura shaka. Yes. Yes, yes. Double portion. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Rashaka. Receive. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes. 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 Open your mouth, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Come on, go ahead and worship. Go ahead and worship, choir. Go ahead and worship, musician. Go ahead and worship, general. Go ahead and worship, minister. Go ahead and worship. Asha. Worship. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Ooh, apostolic anointing is on you now. Holy Ghost anointing is on you now. Open your mouth. Yes. Yes. Yes, that's a power now. Power is on you. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Yes. Come on, somebody worship. Ooh. Open your mouth now, open your mouth. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. 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 Come on, somebody praise him. Somebody praise him like you're crazy. Somebody give the Lord a crazy praise right now. Rabasaka. Somebody praise him. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Yes. Shake him out of a higher. Open your mouth. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, 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 yes. Somebody's about to speak in tongues right now. Somebody's about to speak in tongues right now. Come on, don't stop praising God. Somebody give him praise. Out of your belly, out of your belly. Out of your belly. Stand up and release. Open your mouth now. Open your mouth. Yes, yes, yes. The anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. Come on. The anointing is on you. Open. Bravo. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. 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 My God, my God, my God. Open your mouth. Come on, give him 1 more minute to praise. Come on, give him 1 more minute to praise. praise. Come on, give him one more minute to praise, sir. When the praise goes up, come on, teachers, come on, doctors, come on, nurses, come on, judges, come on, lawyers, come on, bishops, come on, elders, give the Lord a praise. Somebody need a passport. Somebody need the Holy Ghost. Give him one more minute to pray. Open your mouth. Yeah, shut up. I release the Holy Ghost now. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, 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 yes. Receive the Holy Ghost. Oh, yes, that's the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. This is your night. This is your night. This is your night. Yes. Open your mouth. Yes, 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 yes. Come on, praise him. Praise him before you take the car key up. Praise him before you drive out tonight. Praise him before you leave the devil come out. Somebody get up and give the Lord a praise. Rashada. Open your mouth and praise him right now. Somebody praise God in here. Yes, yes, yes. Open your mouth. Ratata. Rama Bosha. Rashama. Yes, yes, yes. You're anointed. You're anointed to speak in tongues. You're anointed to speak in tongues. You're anointed to speak in tongues. You're anointed to worship. You're anointed to speak in tongues. Open your mouth. Yes. 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 Somebody's getting the Holy Ghost over here. Somebody has just gotten the Holy Ghost over here. Somebody praise, and I want to hear the young man praise God over there. Open him out. 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 Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Open your mouth. It's on you, it's on you.
Hallelujah, Jesus, praise you, God. Hallelujah, glory, name of Jesus.
Urusha. Urusha. Yes. Come on, stand up on your feet now, everybody. Stand up on your feet in the back. Stand up on your feet in the middle. Raise your hands to God right now. Rabakasato. Come on, stand and raise your hands like you bless the Lord. Open your mouth. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Don't stop, don't stop. Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop. Come on, somebody. Yes, yes. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop. The anointing is here. Yes. Young man can get the Holy Ghost. Sonnywell can get the Holy Ghost. 6 years of age, but Samuel can get the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Yes, 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 yes. Open your mouth, boy. Open your mouth, boy. Receive the Holy Ghost. Yes, yes, yes. Open your mouth. Come on, speak it out. Speak it out. Open your mouth. Yes, 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 the anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. Yes, yes. Open your mouth. Yes. Somebody worship, somebody worship, somebody worship, somebody worship, somebody worship. My God Almighty, just give God one more minute to praise. Give God one more minute to praise before you quit. Come on, give God one more minute to praise before you quit. Elijah. Come on, put your hands on somebody and tell them, receive the Holy Ghost now. Come on, get your hands on somebody and tell them, receive the Holy Ghost now. Yes. Yes. Holy Ghost, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Open your mouth. Speak it up. He's speaking, he's speaking. Come on, where are the midwives? Where are the midwives? Open your mouth. Yes, it's on you, it's on you. The anointing is on you. The anointing is on you. Open your mouth, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Somebody stand and worship God like you. Know that you know that you know God is a good God. Somebody praise him. A devil wants your praise. Give God your praise before you leave the building. Come on, give God one more minute praise before you leave the building. Open your mouth, open. Yes. Yes! Yes! Yes, 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 yes! It's yours, it's yours! Yes! Somebody shout yes! Somebody shout yes! Somebody shout yes! Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost!
Yes, Lord! Yes, Lord! Yes, Lord.
Everybody look at me. Stand to your feet. We're going to close. But before we do this, I wanted to stand everywhere. If you don't have a baby in your hand, please stand. Radako. Shaka. Stand to your feet. Now, listen to this very carefully. With the authority of your bishop. With the authority of your bishop and the Holy Ghost. We take 3 more minutes for the pool. Everybody say 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Kedosha. Kosha. All right. Everybody look at me now. Look at me now. Please look at me. Please look at me. We need 3 more minutes for the pool. And we can quit. Raka. Those who are sure tonight, standing here, before you take out your car keys for your limousine and your Mercedes Benz, you're sure you're going to heaven, raise your hands quickly. Quickly, you're sure. If you're not sure, don't tell no lie now. Rabakasha. For those who are not sure, you should be up here a long time. All right. Thank you. I'd like to see those who have never been baptized in Jesus' name. Never. You are not yet baptized. I've not yet been baptized in Jesus' name. Slip your hands up. The children. The children, raise your hands if you have not yet been baptized. The teenagers, the adults, come on, let me see about the raise of your hands. One, come up here, come up here, come up here, give them away. I want to hear your worship now. Two, come up here, come over here. Shandabako, Kitamosha. Come on, half a minute gone. Bishop, give me 3 minutes to call to the pool. You should be pushing in this way. You should be pushing in this way. Kusha, come right here. All the unbaptized little boy. Can I share something with you right now? Oh, come on. Come on. All those who have not yet been baptized. Get them away. Rabba Shata. I feel this. Where are the Holy Ghost musician? Your fingers should be going like a... Bring them up here. Bring them up here. Rabba Kashata. Baptized already? Come up here. Rabba Kusha. Bring them up here. Come up here. Baptized already? Baptized already? Ushaba. Baptized already? Let me see the hands of those who have not yet been baptized. Where are the women? Where are the young women who have not yet been baptized? Come on, let me see about the raise of your hands right now. In the back. Shatter. All over. Rabakusha. All right. Keep worshiping. Now. I gotta feel the Holy Ghost. Let it touch 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 the Holy Ghost. Now, listen, 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 listen. I'd like to see that hunger here in the Western world like they have in Africa and other Middle Eastern country. We saw 35,000 children, Bishop, receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. 35,000 children. If you think I'm lying, take your telephone and call Brother Teclamarian in Ethiopia right now. 35,000 children receive dead on count baptism. Dead on count baptism. 164,000 people receive the Holy Ghost in one single service. You see, when you're hungry for God, you don't remember your car, you don't remember your money, you don't remember your shape, you don't remember anything else. You just want to be rapture ready. Somebody say rapture ready. Let the church say rapture ready. Let the church say, let the teachers say rapture ready. Let the lawyers say rapture ready. Rapture ready. Now listen, we have a little boy by the name of Daniel. Daniel is 4. I think I shared it before. Now, is there a 4-year-old here? Is there a 4-year-old? Now we've been in Daniel from he was 3 for him to get baptized, Reverend. And Daniel said, I'm not ready yet. Navia is 3. Navia said, I don't want to go to heaven. She's 3. And then every now and then she come back and said, I want to go to heaven. Now we were at the pool. Are you listening to me? Look at me, please. Keep your car keys safe, right? You are safe. Somebody stir the water, stir the water, stir the water. Come on, you stir the water now. Oh, shut up.
The water is
Daniel coming. Came up to the pool and Daniel said, Daddy, I said, yes, Daniel. He said, I want to be baptized in Jesus' name. I said, when? He said, now, Daddy. Now the baptizers are in the pool. You know, baptizers are in the pool. I was sweat and hot. But when I see Daniel decide, are you with me? I pull my jacket, Bishop. I pull off everything. I slip in the changing room. Brought him in the changing room. Change him out. I said, Daniel, you serious? Daniel said, yes, Daddy, I want to be baptized. I took him down in the water. Baptized Daniel. The mother is here to bear me witness. Where is Sister Clark? Rabbi, somebody pray for Sister Clark. Pray for her. She looks soft and trim, but she's tough. Taking her into those demonic territory in South Africa, Ethiopia, all over. You pray for her. My God Almighty. I said, Daniel, you serious? Took him in the water. Baptized Daniel in Jesus' name. Before I finish that, let me tell you what happened. Some of you sitting here holding back the young people. You know how much the devil is working hard to get them. They caught 2 little children behind the church. 1-4, 1-5. Their clothes off. You know what they were doing? I leave that to you. When they brought the 4-year-old one in my office and I asked, how do you see that? Where do you know about this thing? They said, I saw it on TV, Pastor. Watch them TV and them children. We're not going to leave our little young children to internet and let the devil... Oh, I don't hear that. Somebody stand up on your feet and say the blood, the man. We're going home, but say the blood 2 times before you leave. Stand up on your feet and shout the blood 2 more times before you drive out.
The blood.
I talked to the parents. I gave the parents back the 2 little children. I said, stay guard around them. Now, when I change Daniel, get ready, singers, get ready, organists, 2 more minutes. When I change Daniel, clothes off and dress him in the changing room. My God Almighty. Daniel said, Daddy, I'm baptized now in Jesus' name. And you know, they thought Daniel wouldn't talk. We had to send Daniel to a special school for speech to talk. And everybody said, Daniel won't talk. No, Daniel can't stop talking. I don't hear the folks. Every pen is a microphone. I lose all my nice pen. Daniel broke up all my pen. Everything is a microphone. Daniel preach morning, evening, and preach till him wet sometimes. I don't hear the folks. When I finish baptizing Daniel and dress him, Daniel said, Daddy, I'm now baptized in Jesus' name.
I said, yes. He said, can I get the mic? No. I said, yes, Daniel, you can get the mic. He said, can I preach now? I said, yes, Daniel, you can preach now. I don't hear the folks. Four, how old are you? How old are you? How old are you? How old are you? Four. This is the, you're going to lead them in the pool tonight. This is Daniel. Ooh, how old are you? 12. How old are you? Come on, come down here. Everybody point to this 12-year-old girl. Quickly. There's a girl that gave birth the other day in England. 10 years of age, and she gave birth to twin. 10. It's ripe for heaven. How old are you? How old? 9. Much older than Daniel. Is there anybody else who have not yet been baptized in here? My God Almighty. There's a little girl I was preaching at King's Chapel. 4 years of age. Received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. They had to hold her up like this. I tell you something, nobody grew up in my house is going to be left back when the church is raptured. Oh, shut up. Let the church of Holy Ghost. Let the church of Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Let the church of Holy Ghost. Let the church of Holy Ghost. Now, listen, listen, parents, listen. When they get baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost, you don't have a problem. When you leave them to the internet, pornography and all kinds of stuff, that's when the devil takes their minds. Now they are ready to go to the pool. I want the parents to stand behind them. I was a little tat when I took it on. They gave me 3 days. I passed it. They gave me a week. They gave me 7 days. They gave me 2 weeks. They gave me 3 weeks. They gave me 6 months. And I'm still here. Ooh. Let me see the hands of those who backslid. These are going in the pool now. All backsliders, raise your hands. All those who failed the Lord, you're in the building. Come on, quickly, raise your hands. Quickly, quickly. One over there. Backsliders, come on, raise your hands quickly. Come over here, come over here. Rababo Shata. Come over here. We're taking a few extra minutes for this. This missionary, look at this missionary. Where are the other hands? Raise them quickly, quickly. Come over here. Come over here. You put your hand up. You fail the Lord. God says he's going to marry to you. Come over here. Rabbi, God's going to use you in the church. Somebody bring her quickly. Bring her quickly. Rabbi Sato. I see the heaven open right now. That somebody shall revival. Somebody shall revival. Somebody shall revival. Somebody shall revival. Now, when you see the children start to go down in the pool, it's a sign of revival. Every parent, stand up if you don't have arthritis. Rabbi, we put the blood of every arthritis in here tonight. Rabbi Sato. Point your hands to the man and said, God, cover them. Come on, release some blood over here on these children. Now, they're going to be taking on the name of Jesus. We cover them by the blood. We cover them by the blood. Now the baptizer is ready. You're going to change your address tonight. Amen. I was younger than you when I did that. You're going to change your address tonight by taking on. I don't hear the musician, man. Chuckling, man. You need to be chuckling, man. I'm a musician, do you know, man? Play the music, man, in the Holy Ghost. 2 more minutes and we do the baptism. Rakosha, come over here, come over here. A backslider here, come quickly. Rasha. Now, I want somebody to take them to the pool. And if the parents are here, go with them quickly. Stand to your feet, stand to your feet. If the parents are here, come on, take them to the pool. Young man, you're going to be a prophet. Oh, some of the parents are not here. Some of the parents are not here. All right, stand to your feet, everybody. Come on, lift your hands and give God a praise right now. Yes, yes, yes. Everybody stand, everybody stand. This sister was speaking in tongues. Speaking in tongues.
Same, I'm with the Lord, but I'm coming back.
coming. Come on, somebody lift your hands and give God praise. Come on, lift your hands and give God praise. Lift your hands and give God praise. You have heard the preacher tonight. He preached out of his soul. He preached out of his spirit. Don't let anything happen and you'll miss the rapture. Come on, stand to your feet, stand to your feet, stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. The Holy Ghost power is right anyhow. Right anyhow. Same call. Right anyhow. The Holy Ghost power is right anyhow. Amen. Amen. Same call. The Holy Ghost power is right anyhow. Right anyhow. Right anyhow. The Holy Ghost power.
Hey! soul.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God.
My Lord, so sweet. My Lord, so sweet. My Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet.
My Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet, my Lord is sweet. My Lord is sweet. My Lord.
Jesus someday. Comforter has come. He brings joy to my soul. He brings joy to my soul. You can tell the world about this. You can tell the nation. Yeah.
set me free. I'm gonna dance, 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 dance. All night, all night. What is it about Jesus? What is that for me? What is it about Jesus? And how he set me free? I'm gonna dance.
On time, it's 12 o'clock midnight.